Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this week's edition of CineKid Television Theater. I'm Bob Clark, the Executive Director of CineKid Enterprises Incorporated. For the next 30 minutes, you'll be enjoying really creative cable television. This is a show that's designed and developed by our kids. They're youngsters who range in age from 7 to 17 years. They come to us from 40 neighboring communities, and they share one thing in common: a deep and abiding interest in the world of communications. This is their program, and I know that you're going to enjoy their efforts. We start this evening by continuing the mystery that involves the Carter family. And if you remember, 2 weeks ago, our chapter ended when Don brought his little brother back from the basement. He was unconscious, and his mother was very upset. The adventure continues now on the Clintons.
Yes?
Mother.
Weigh a ton.
66 pounds, and it's all muscle.
So, kiddo, how does your head feel?
Better.
That's good. Are you hungry?
I'm starved.
Good, because I have a whole lot of food in the kitchen just ready to be prepared. Batter's all ready for your favorite. Pancakes, and bacon, and orange juice and hot chocolate. And you know where I went?
Where?
To the bakery. And do you know what I got?
No.
Donuts. Jelly. Mm. So how does that sound?
Good.
Good.
Thanks, Mom.
You're welcome. Oh, and the doctor said that you're not supposed to be running all over the place, so I want you to stay right there, okay?
Okay.
Okay, it'll only take a couple minutes.
Okay. Thanks, Mom.
You're welcome, and work on that appetite.
So, Chip, how do you feel?
Well, I didn't want to tell Mom, but I still have a little headache.
All right. Now explain to me what really happened in the basement.
Well, I went down looking for the hand, and bang! I got knocked out, and that's how I got this headache.
Chip, next time you go in the basement, will you take me with you?
Why?
Because I care about you.
Okay.
Promise?
Promise.
You stay here, I'll get it.
Okay.
Oh, wow, come in, come in.
Where's the patient?
Right here.
Hey, how you doing, big guy?
Hi. Hi, Chip.
Hi, Chip.
Your brother told me how much you like soda, so I brought you some.
Thanks.
Yeah, and I was going by the store when it opened, and well, they call this a gift basket. It's got cheese and crackers and candy and all this other neat stuff.
Thanks.
Here, I brought you some games since I need to be around the house for a while. Checkers and dominoes.
Thanks.
And they are my brother, so if you see them, don't tell them you got them from me. Then I'm not gonna kiss you. Pretzels.
I love pretzels.
Sorry, here.
Thanks.
Well, the doctor said he has to get a few days of rest. And I'm sure he appreciates all this, right?
Oh, yeah, thanks.
Well, we gotta be going anyway. Give me a call sometime, though, okay?
Right.
See you later.
Bye.
Enjoy the soda, Chip.
Bye.
Yeah, yes.
Here, I got you some magazines. They're brand new.
Thanks.
Just don't tell anybody.
Give me a call. Bye. Give me a call now.
In a hurry, Duke.
Yeah, I have to go somewhere. See ya.
Okay, see ya. That was really nice.
Yeah.
Where did these magazines come from?
Duke.
Duke? Duke? Ms. McGowan, come in.
Hello? Is your mother in?
Chipper!
How are you? Oh, Chip, yes. How are you?
Oh, I'm feeling better.
That's good. Is your mother in?
Yes, she's in the kitchen. You can go right in.
Okay. You see, I figured I'd better see her because, well, the accident did happen in this building.
She'll understand.
I hope you feel better. I better go talk to her.
These magazines are new.
Yeah, but they're for me. Oh, but you can have one.
Thanks. Busy. Ms. Pressman, come in.
My sister would have come too, but she had an orchestra rehearsal. Chip, how are you?
Oh, I'm feeling better.
That's good. This is a present from my sister and me. To get well present.
Thanks.
Is your mother home?
Yes, she's in the kitchen with Ms. McGowan. You can go in.
I have to talk to her. Bless your heart.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas around here.
You know, if I knew this was going to happen, I should do this more often.
No, you don't. It's probably the delivery boy.
Could be.
This is Mason. Come in. Are you here to see Chip?
No.
I'm sure you heard. He was knocked out in the basement.
Yes, I did hear. Is your mother in?
Well, yes. She's got some company right now. But I'm sure she'll see you. She's in the kitchen.
Do you know where Carla is?
No, I don't, Mrs. Mason. I'm sorry.
I got home last night. Found a note. Seems she ran away from home.
Oh?
Yes, she's just like her father. They leave home. They don't care how I feel.
I don't like her.
I know what you mean.
Can I open my present now?
Sure, go ahead.
Oh, wow, look at these.
Oh, nice.
You want one?
No, thanks. Remember, Mom's making breakfast.
How about that? And the mystery will continue next week, so you stay with us. We're going to discover who is at the bottom of things. And now for a little music. From the world of the Clintons to the world of vaudeville, the great entertainer himself, the sounds unmistakably those of Al Jolson. Our performer, young Matt Harlan. Ladies and gentlemen, you ain't heard nothing yet as Jolson sings again.
Know that I'm in love. wonderful. Oh, the sun shines bright, the world's all right, cause I'm in love. There's a rainbow around my shoulder, and it fits me like a glove. Let it blow and storm, I'll be warm, cause I'm in love. Hallelujah, how the folks will stare when they see that great big solitaire. Got my little sugar, my baby is going away. Yes, sir, there's a rainbow around my shoulder, and the sky is blue above. And I'm shouting so the world will know that I'm in love.
Thank you, Matt. Another fine job. And now from Al Jolson to the youngest members of the Cinekid organization. This is sort of a behind the scenes with the little kids at Cinekid as we take our mobile video cameras to record the action as it occurs here each and every Saturday morning at Cinekid. At that time, between the hours of 10 a.m. and 12 noon, the boys and girls of elementary age, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 years of age, participate in a program that we call Tyro, and they learn how to operate the video equipment and how to put on makeup and how to design graphics, all of the things that are a part of our secondary program. So this is a documentary that provides you with a chance to see that indeed, even the little guys work with the equipment here at Cinekid. Let's watch Eye on Tyro.
Every winter, the kids in Tyro create their own productions, and they are called the Tyro Rock Concerts. The rock concerts are actually videos to music, done in the same format as videos seen on the MTV channel.
I thought it was a really good thing, you know, to do. It's exciting, and it's like a new thing that, you know, like, it's kind of like MTV. So, you know, I thought that was really great.
A lot of time and energy goes into these videos. In January, the kids in Tyro split into several different groups. Each group meets on Saturday mornings. They pick a song that each member of the group likes and then script out what they will do to match the song. Of course, there are mixed feelings in the beginning.
At first, I thought it was kind of strange, but then I really liked it when I got to, you know, I got to know what we were doing and how we were doing it.
I think it's going to be fun.
When the group agrees on a basic plot, they write down their ideas in an organized fashion. Usually, the videos are done two different ways. Some videos tell a story, while others are done in the concert fashion, and sometimes a mixture of both. In the videos with stories, the actors and actresses try to convey a feeling about the song. Girls Just Want to Have Fun and Turn It On Again are just two of them.
We're going to be girls coming over to a sleepover, and we're going to be in a room, and we're going to start out like good, cute, kitty girls, and then we're going to come out like punk rockers.
It tells emotions and, you know, how the person felt, if he felt sad or happy, you know.
Assisting the kids with scripting, shooting, props, and makeup are the Tyro staff.
The Tyro staff is helping us do that.
After the videos are shot, Tyro staff members edit the productions. The rock concerts are then premiered during the dance marathon. This year promises to be the best yet.
Our thanks to John Bethard, one of our students, and his production crew for another exceptional job. This is their sequence. And I think it's especially nice, not only that we're able to take the cameras behind the scenes, but that the older members of the organization take such an active interest in the lives and the progress of the youngest members of Cinekid. Our motto is, each one, reach one. And by that we mean that once you've developed a proficiency, that you share those skills with the younger kids. Good job. Okie dokie. Now, obviously, in addition to watching cable television, a lot of us go to the movies. And to provide us with an update on some of the newer features, here's Frank Smith and his series, What's New at the Movies.
Hi, I'm Frank Smith for What's New at the Movies. Tonight's film is Lassiter, starring the very versatile actor Tom Selleck. Selleck had a starring role in High Road to China and is a TV personality on the hit show Magnum PI. He has teamed up with Jane Seymour and Lauren Hutton. Special effects and costumes makes for an action-packed, exciting film, Lassiter. With us, and in the weeks to come, we'll be previewing several more films, including Paul Newman's new film, Harry and Son, in which he not only stars, he also directs. Another film is Against All Odds, starring Jeff Bridges. So, I'll see you next week. I'm Frank Smith for What's New at the Movies. Good night.
Thank you, Frank, and I sincerely hope that this kind of a production gives you folks, especially those of you who have families, a chance to see, you know, what's in the theaters that you may be interested in seeing. We're especially grateful to our friends in Hollywood for sharing these clips. It certainly is an asset to our program to be able to bring right into your homes some of the footage from some major Hollywood productions. Okay, from Hollywood to a little log cabin nestled on the shores of a quiet lake under some spreading chestnut trees. You know the place. Unfortunately, there's a little problem in the log cabin, and that's the fact that some weeks ago, while working on his science fair project, Jimbo put together some creation that he spilled on himself and turned invisible. That's where things are as we go now to Uncle Flywheel's workshop.
I'm waiting.
Yes, sir, Uncle Flywheel.
Don't try any of that yes, sir stuff on me. It won't work this time. Start talking.
About what?
You know.
I'm afraid I don't.
About you and Jimbo.
Me and Jimbo.
Mm-hmm. You can start by telling me just where Jimbo is.
Well, I haven't seen him for a while.
Neither has anyone else in the family. And they tell me some pretty strange things have been happening.
Strange?
Mm-hmm. Bucky, why don't you come on over here and sit down?
You want me to come over there and sit down?
Yes, I'd like you to come over here and sit down.
You want me to walk over there and sit down in the chair next to you?
I want you to come over here and sit in this chair. This chair.
You want me to walk over there and sit down in the chair next to you?
Yes.
Okay. I'm walking across the room to sit down in the chair, which is next to you.
Very good, Bucky. What is going on here?
Well, you see, it all started with the science fair projects.
The science fair project?
Uh-huh. Well, and you see, what would you do if I told you that one of the kids, while they were working on their science fair project, they had a teensy little accident.
That was no accident.
Quiet, I'm talking.
Bucky, what was that?
What was what?
I distinctly heard Jimbo's voice.
Really?
Really? Really? Where is Jimbo? The truth!
I can't tell a lie, Uncle Flywheel.
I'm right here, Uncle Flywheel.
Right where? Bucky, is he in the trunk?
Uh-uh.
He's behind the TV set.
Mm-mm.
Well, then where is he?
Jimbo, come on over here and sit down on the arm of the chair, like you usually do.
Hi, Uncle Flywheel.
Hi, Jimbo.
That tickles.
Jimbo?
He's ticklish.
Huh. Bucky, why can't I see him?
Well, you see, he's working on a science fair project, and, well, he mixed together a big batch of chemicals, and, well...
I turned invisible!
No. No. Oh, no. No. I'm having a dream, and I'm going to wake up anyway. Watch. Oh, no. Why me?
Now, let's visit with Mark Weaver, get down the hallway and take a peek and see what's on the CineKid bulletin board.
Hi, I'm Mark Weaver.
And I'm John Bethard.
And this Saturday night at CineKid's Family Movie Night, we will be presenting McIntosh
and TJ, starring Roy Rogers.
Roy Rogers came out of his 20-year retirement to shoot his latest film with Clay O'Brien. Tickets are $2. For more information, call 659-4696.
Happy trails to you until we meet again. Happy trails to you.
Thank you, Mark. And for those of you who have not had an opportunity to see the King of the Cowboys in operation, and for you adults who remember Roy Rogers and Dale Evans, this is a film that you really should see. This is the most recent motion picture that Roy made. And if you're a kid between the ages of 7 and 17, if you're a parent who has a youngster who's about that age, who may be interested in performing or working with the gear, making films or what have you, give you an opportunity to see the CineKid campus and perhaps become a part of the wonderful world of CineKid. Okay? I hope to see you all this weekend, and I'm sure that you'll be watching us next week. Same time, same cable channel. Until then, this is Bob Clark. Good night, and God bless.